individual in economics class. And we formed a relationship because one of us tutored the other one. I'll let you guys decide which one did the tutoring and which one didn't. But I'd like to introduce Mr. Michael Oldroyd. Standing champion of 2008 and 2009. Just like we say with class, it doesn't matter how long ago the award was, we still won it. So Mike's going to do a little bit of stand-up for us for about 5 to 7 minutes. And then after that, everyone's free to go. Enjoy your evenings, but enjoy your evening. Here you go, Mike.
You in to the relationship. I adopted you. I discovered you.
I'm sorry. This is the second job that I've hired Mike to. The first job was at a cookie store, and we made cookies together.
I was like, I like making the cookie dough this way. And you're like, Mike, do it this way. Count out the eggs. It's got to be a specific number. Your method doesn't work. We got to do it this way. And we're arguing about how to make cookies. That is not how I wanted to open my set tonight, but it's better to go with it because that was a great introduction and I appreciate it. This is true stand-up comedy, guys, right? We're all standing up watching me do comedy. And I appreciate that. Standing ovation already, you know? Welcome to London, sagacious consultants. I can do that because my ancestors are from England. Oldroyd is an English name, actually. It means a clearing in a meadow, which I have no idea what the heck that means. It makes me think of Bambi. So when you think of me, think of Bambi, if you want. Or you can think of old R2-D2, because I feel like I would be Luke Skywalker's right-hand man if I was a robot. You know what I mean? All right, think of something funnier, Mike. Keep going, though. You know? We're going to get into a flow here in a second. But I appreciate you guys coming in. Hopefully everyone had safe travels. Bringing plus one, significant others. I brought my mom this time around. Mother's Day weekend. Yeah. That obviously means that I'm not in a relationship. It means I'm still single. Steve has done stand-up before, so I should listen to the suggestions. But yeah, my mom, I'm going to talk a little bit about her. Obviously, she's a sweet lady right there. She's half Filipino. She's my angel. I'm a 30-year-old mama's boy, is what I'm trying to say, guys. But don't mess with her, okay? She'll she used to throw shoes at me when I would, you know, act up as a kid. And I feel like it's very scary. I feel like she would be the best Mortal Kombat player of all time, you know what I mean? Michael, no matter who she's fighting. You guys having a good time in the back there? But yeah, obviously, it's been almost 2 years since the acquisition, guys. I want to start off by saying we should all pat ourselves on the back, everybody from Accenture and Sagacious, for fighting in every way we possibly can to make this the best acquisition it possibly can be. Everyone in here is worth our time. I remember the day I found out that we were acquired. It was the same time you guys found out. And the first thought that went through my head was, damn, I'm really glad I didn't get that Sagacious Consultants tattoo that I was thinking about. You know, the one on my lower back that I talked about a few years. But you know what, 1 year in, I was starting to see some light. You know, there's a lot of unknown at that time, right? 1 year in, 2 years in now, more and more light at the end of the tunnel. I'm actually still considering getting a Sagacious Consultant set too.
And all part of the extension.
Yes! That is my punchline, thank you. Thank you. See, he's a comedian too. Or I could put 1 + 1 = 3. You know, there's different.
Business as usual.
Yeah. I was just. anyway, though, you know, I've learned a lot. I'm sure we all have, you know, faced with different challenges over the last couple of years, even before. Obviously, this entire thing from very beginning to very end has been a lot of growth opportunity. Some things can't be applied to real life, though, right? I'll give you an example of where I try to take something that I've learned and apply it, and it hasn't gone well. I was going on a date recently because I'm single, and I felt like it was a pretty good fit, you know? I was like, I think we really compliment each other. And she was already on the way out. And as she's walking out, I'm like, seriously, give this another chance. 1 + 1 = 3. I never heard from her again. Another thing, when I have guests over to my apartment now, or not anymore because it doesn't work, right? Another thing that didn't work is trying to get people to sign waivers when I offer them refreshments or drinks. When I have Kyle over, I'm like, Kyle, put that M&M down. You haven't signed the waiver yet. I don't want you choking on it. Hey, Mike, are you making fun of Sagacious right now? Sorry, I can't be in London, but I just wanted to interject for a second. Hey, everybody, hope you guys made it out safely. Mike, Jesse, it's okay. I'm just being respectful.
It's not Harry.
Everybody wants to hear Jesse at some point, so he was helping me out the last couple days, so I appreciate that. Anyway, though, I did want to close out here with a couple last things. You know, it's funny that Kyle brought me up. I remember when he hired me, I was the first operations person. We were working out of his apartment at the time, and I kept on saying, Kyle, let me take a nap. Every day I would ask him if I could take naps a few times a day. I was like, do you want me to create value for you, or do you want me to follow processes and be a robot? You know? And you know what his answer was? He got out this bullwhip. He said, you see that human-sized hamster wheel over there? Get back on that and keep powering the lights. But yeah, guys, it's great. I'm just going to close by saying, make sure you don't forget to wish your moms Happy Mother's Day on Sunday. And Mom, I love you.